that's where you can spawn vehicles for outside. And you do have to take the metro. We'll go as far as the spaceport. As long as it doesn't lag down. Like that.
All of our landing areas are currently full. Please hold for assignment.
Still trying to land me. And yes, you do have to wait for the metro. Unfortunately, that one is bugged and not saying what time. What are you looking at, bitch? That is amazing. It's like looking through real glass. Right now we're at gate 4. We'll be going to the Metro Center and then taking the Metro Center to the spaceport. These two are still in development, which will be the Central Business District. And Leibson Station, not sure how to pronounce that. But that would take you to the big, big building. So no, we cannot go there yet, unfortunately. Wonder which one's gonna get here first. Bug. Oh, sorry. Hurry up and wait. Hurry up and wait. I'm thinking this one. Now it's really glitch. Now what's really weird is that you hear sound right now, but they haven't finished it. So when we leave, it goes absolutely silent, which is creepy, especially with half spawned characters riding along with you. And yes, you are actually traveling through the city on the metro in real time. This isn't a loading screen, you're actually moving within the game. So someone could be flying outside and see me in this. As you can see, the frame rates have dropped quite a lot. Far away stuff doesn't look bad, but when it gets up close, you can definitely tell. Just gets quieter. You can see where my ship is. Way, way, way far away now. Now the air is polluted here, which is why some of these characters are wearing bags on their heads, which is hilarious. It's just like being in DC. It's just like living in DC. Just follow the lines. Seconds. Ooh. Bam. Just in time. And this will take us to the spaceport. Eventually we will be able to go into that building, and yes, they are going to build it up to where you can go to the top of that thing. And right now the only reason they really have no fly zones is because a lot of the regular buildings are still kind of polygon looking, not exactly real looking, so they're still building it. This wasn't even supposed to be released yet, but for some reason they went ahead and released it. Which was awesome. Another player. And as you can see, there are no load screens. This is all generated as you go. Usually this is where you would spawn your ship, but they even went as far as turning the screens off. Whoa, never saw this before. Huh. Interesting. I still haven't explored all this. And this is where you can buy a new ship. That's a racer. Another, I believe, racer. This is one of the ships you can start out with. It's not a bad little ship. I took it for a flight and I was actually surprised with how nimble it is. I prefer the Gladius to start out with, but this is still a good ship. That's a mining rig where you can actually mine elements with a forward laser. And that ship to the left of us is the other ship I own. Not the first one, the big one. I also own that one, which is a Mustang, which is the other starter ship you can start with. I suggest that one. Now this isn't exactly the one that I have. I'm not sure which one this is, but I own the Constellation Andromeda, which looks just like this, except it has huge guns on the bottom and top. This one is, if it'll bring it up, I'm not sure. Usually they allow you in these things, but I guess not. And even though I own this ship, it also comes with a mini ship on the back. Unfortunately, they're not working yet. They're still working out the bugs for docking and all that. It's not coming up. And then this is a brand new ship within the game. This is a drop ship with big, huge turrets on either side. And then that is the cockpit, which is oddly on the bottom. My cockpit is right out front. But that is Hurston, everyone. Or I should say, Lorville. The brand new first huge city world in Star Citizen. Enjoyed my presentation. Bye.